governor is sort of reading from the book of how to prevent crime, as opposed to reading from the book of how to create opportunity. Those are not the same, so it's, and even the assembly is only going to take some chapters out of their book and put it in the governor's book. He is sort of insisting that he book of how to.
Got it.
But the mayor is saying, New York is
good morning. This meeting of the Committee on the Justice System is called to order. We are here this morning with Councilmember Alan Mazel and Councilmember Andy Cohen, and we are considering resolution number 641 by the public advocate, Jumani Williams. The resolution 641 calls on the State Division of Criminal Justice Services, the Office of Court Administration, and New York City's District Attorneys to expunge the records of all city misdemeanor marijuana convictions. As we anticipate that the state legislature will legalize recreational marijuana this year, taking care of those with previous misdemeanor convictions will be a crucial step in moving past an era of overcriminalization and over-policing of primarily communities of color. A conviction, even one for a misdemeanor, can wreak havoc on a person's life and derail their future. I am so pleased that some of our district attorneys are already taking steps on their own. For example, the district attorneys in both Brooklyn and Manhattan have dismissed open warrants for marijuana possession. And in Brooklyn, DA Eric Gonzalez has gone even further, establishing a program to vacate prior convictions that could reach as many as 20,000 eligible Brooklynites if they're able to get the word out to everyone who can apply. So all of you who are here today, and particularly my colleague from Brooklyn, and those of you who might be watching at home, please let people in Brooklyn know that there is an opportunity to have their prior convictions vacated, and they should reach out to the Brooklyn District Attorney's Office. With that, I would ask the clerk to call the roll and vote on resolution 641. And for what it's worth, the chair recommends a yes vote.
William Martin, committee clerk, roll call vote committee on the justice system. Chair Lantzman.
Yes.
Cohen.
Permission to explain my vote?
Yes, sir.
Just very briefly, the chair knows, I was a law secretary in the court system for many years, and my judge would, because he was acting supreme, would have to do criminal arraignments periodically. And I cannot tell you how formative it was, the impact it made on me, watching, you know, person after person coming up and, you know, being released to ACD or whatever, or just for time served, spending 24 hours through the system for smoking a joint, like on their curb, sitting in a parked car. It was really, it felt like a colossal waste of time, but also the impact that it had on people's lives. So I think this is a good day. I hope the state legislature takes our advice. I'm sure they're waiting for our resolution, but I proudly vote aye.
Mizell. By a vote of 3 in the affirmative, 0 in the negative, and no abstentions, resolution has been adopted by the committee.
Thank you all very much, and this meeting is adjourned.
Actually, let me go sit over here.
Huffer.
Yes.